gonna go ahead and get this cow in right now. So I'm going to start with the darkest darks, which is what I would do automatically with any oil painting. Any painting that I would be painting would be broken down into larger shapes as it is right here. However, it'll be on the darker side of, you know, what the final color is going to be, because I need to have some room here to work with to build up paint. I never could understand why things were done the way they were done until I came up with my own way of painting. And basically, once I was able to do that, I call it artist shorthand. Every artist is going to be different. You know, there's rules to painting, yes, but are you going to be able to make sense of those rules? That's up to you. For me, I couldn't make sense of all of the rules, so I ended up listening to them, but basically coming up with my own, I guess you could say, interpretation of it. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put in some background. And again, I'm not sure how I'm going to do this background, so I'm going to just come in with, I guess you could say, local color. So in between light and dark, or almost dark, would be my local color. Something about that right now. Thank you. I do need to establish a cast shadow. And when I'm looking at the source, it's actually out through here. So let's see about getting that reestablished. We're gonna get started on the cow. I'm happy with the background so far. I've got a lot of colors here on my palette from the background that I can pick up and use. Let me show you for an example. Here you can see I have all these colors that I used in the background with the big brush. And I can just go into these colors now to get the grays that I need. This might come off. It's not reading well. It's actually distracting. So I think for now I'm going to take it off. Just kind of go like that for now.